Hello, my name is Frederick Anefi. Stay safe, learn Excel under 2 minutes. Here we have a sample data specifically for HR practitioners who handle salary, and they have to calculate the total number of hours worked over time, and based on that they calculate the salary or the total pay which the person needs to be paid at the end of the month. So we have a data here where we have the basic salary, we have the time the employee comes in, we have the break time, that is the start to the finish, we have the time the person leaves the office. Now we want to calculate the total hours the person really works. Simply we'll use the equal sign. So first we'll use the start time for the break, open parent, minus the time they come in, plus the time they leave the office. So we open our parenthesis, the time they leave the office minus the time they completed or they finished their break. So that will give us a figure. So this is really a number. We want to calculate it into hours. All that you have to do is multiply it by 24. That's 24 hours. So we close our parenthesis and we multiply it by 24. So what this means is that the person really worked for 9 hours, some people worked for 7 hours, some worked for negative. So the negative means that they worked in a midnight shift, that's from a p.m. to an a.m. That's why we have the negative. But there should be a way to correct this. And to correct this, we will use the mod function in Excel. So what the mod function will do is that we can just go into the function by just using the F2 to go to the edit mode. Then we just input in the mod function after our formula. So comes the mod function. So we open our parenthesis, then comma. It needs to be in the one. So we have a one. Then we close our parenthesis. Where's our divisor? Okay, our divisor needs to be here. So one. Then we delete the rest. Okay. So we are multiplying the whole mod by the 24. So we use a control enter to enter. So you see that it takes care of the negatives. So what it means is that this is the actual total hours worked by each employee. Now we know that by regular hours, international standard person is supposed to work for 8 hours. So now we pick the 8 hours out. So we use the if function. So if, open our parenthesis, the logical test will be that if the total hours worked is greater than the regular hours we know, that's 8 hours, we use the F4 to block it. What outcome should we get? Then we should pick the 8 hours, then comma. If it's not so, then we should pick the hours in under the total hours. So that's N6. Then we close our parenthesis, then we enter. So that gives us the 8 hours. We can just select the whole range, go into the edit mode, use the, so we need to block this, so F4 to block that. We enter, so we can select the whole range, then go to the edit mode, use a control enter to complete for all. So what it means is that some worked 8 hours, some worked less than the 8 hours. Now we want to calculate the overtime hours. So the overtime hours will just be the difference between the total hours minus the regular hours. So N6 minus the regular hours. So that will be the overtime hours. So this means that this person worked 1.2 overtime hours. We can just select the whole range, go into the edit mode and use the control enter to complete for all. So those who were not up to 8 hours, you can see that they have overtime to be zero. You can see this one to zero. So quickly, we want to calculate for the regular pay. So the regular pay means that when you work for 8 hours, you get your basic salary. A basic salary. So all that we do is that we, so it will be the 8 hours here divided by the base, that's the normal 8 hours one needs to work. Then we use the F4 to block it. We close our parenthesis. We want to follow the arithmetic board function, so times the basic salary. Then we use enter, so that gives us 1,232 cedis 50 pesos, which means that this person worked for full 8 hours, so you get his full basic salary. So then we use the, select the whole range, go into the edit mode, use a control enter to really complete for all. What I mean that those who are not up to, or who didn't work up to the regular 8 hours, they will have their basic salary less by 10, less by, or the minimum say it was prorated, so to be less by a certain factor, which means they won't earn the full salary. Now, if you want to do for the overtime says that you get 10% of your basic salary per hour for any overtime hour you work. So simply it will be equal to the overtime. So we'll have your, open our parenthesis, we'll have the 10%, so block times your basic salary. You close the parenthesis, times the overtime work or the overtime hours, then you enter. So that gives us an overtime pay of 147 Ghana cedis, 91 pesos. So simply you can just select the range, go into the edit mode, that's F2, then just use the control enter to complete for all. So you can see the completion for all. It means those who had zero mean they didn't get any overtime, and those who had the overtime hours have some amounts. Then quickly you can just calculate the total pay. So what will be the total pay? It will just be equal to the regular pay plus the overtime pay. Then you can use the control enter to complete for all. So that will be the pay or the salary at the end of the month for each person. So this can really be a dashboard where then the formulas are really in there, and all that you have to do is just update it. And the moment you update the time, automatically you get your output. So assuming that for the following month, a particular person maybe comes in earlier and goes on with the same time. Let's say this person starts from 8:45. You can see that automatically it's updated here. This is how smart you can really learn Excel. Continue to follow us on this channel, Fred Excel, and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.